Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Komal cover Shekhawat and I hope you all are doing good and keeping safe. So I create videos on how to do econometric analysis using SPSS data, EViews and R. So if you are new to my channel, please click on the subscribe button and you can also join my Telegram group for further queries and discussions. I'm attaching the link of the same in the description box. So do join the group and follow the videos. So in this video, I'm going to discuss how to run non-linear autoregressive distributed lag model in EViews, that is NARDL model. So it was requested by many subscribers to create a video on NARDL model, and here it is. So let's get started. So first of all, the question is, why do we need to apply an ARDL model? See, there are always presence of some form of asymmetries or non-linearities in economic variables. We can see this as an economic variable might have both a positive or a negative change. For instance, price of petrol, price of oil, GDP of a country, exports, imports, etc. Right? Other regression models assume that a change in explanatory variable has the same effect over time, which may not be appropriate as we know in general because the variable might have both a positive or a negative change. Moreover, the conventional co-integration test does not capture the asymmetries or non-linearities in macroeconomic variables. However, numerous techniques over time have been introduced to account these asymmetries. NARDL model is a very nascent technique proposed by Shin et al. In 2014, and it incorporates asymmetries both in short run and in long run. So, before employing NARDL model, please make ensure that the concerned variables in your study are stationary. None of the variables should be integrated of order 2 or stationary at second difference. This means that first check that all the concerned variables are stationary at level or at first difference. I'm also attaching the link in the description box for how to check unit root of a series in EViews. So first import your file. For that, go to File, Open, Foreign Data is Work File, and then you can locate your Excel file, select it and open it, right? So as you can see, the file has been imported. Now suppose I want to study the association between GDP of a country and its exports. So you can see here one of the variable is exports and the other one is GDP. So GDP is the dependent variable in my study and exports is the independent variable. Okay. There are total 50 observations. Now to run the NARDL model, you need to first create a positive or a negative change in the independent variable, and you need to also generate the lagged values of the dependent and independent variables. So for that, you need to first run some of the commands for that to generate the required variables. So first of all, so in the command box, write the command for generating the lagged variable for the dependent variable, and the command is as follows. So GDP is the dependent variable in my study, and the command for generating dependent variables lag is as follows. Then press enter. So you can see DGDP has been generated. Now similarly, you need to generate the lagged variable for the independent variable. Similarly, the command for generating lagged for independent variable is as follows, and then press enter. So you can see here DEX has also been generated. Now to generate the positive and negative variable, to show the positive or negative change in the independent variable, the command are as follows. So you need to write these commands in the command box. So these commands are as follows: generate a positive for the independent variable, then generate a negative for the independent variable. So here n, you can see the ex is the independent variable, underscore n represents the negative change. So this is the command for generating a negative change in the independent variable. And similarly, ex underscore p, so p here shows the positive change in the independent variable. So once you have written down all these commands, press enter and you can see all these new variables have been generated. So this is exn is the negative change in the independent variable. This dex underscore p is the positive change in the independent variables. So you can see all these new variables have been generated. Now to run NARDL model, you need to go to quick estimate equation, and in the method section you need to select stepwise least squares. Okay, now in the equation specification box you need to write down the dependent variable followed by the independent variables. Okay, so in this equation specification box you need to first write the independent variable which has been generated with lag, and then C for the constant here, and the lag of the GDP, that is the lag of the dependent variable, and the positive change in the independent variable and a negative change in the independent variable. So you can see here there are three independent variables now. Then in the list of search regressors, the equation specification in the first box contains the lag of dependent variable, C for the constant, and three independent variables. That is the first lag of the dependent variable, then the first lag of the sum of positive change in the independent variable, and first lag of the sum of negative change in the independent variable, right? So in the list of search regressors, the equation will be as follows. There will be a lag of dependent variable with up to 4 lags, then there will be C for the constant, and sum of positive change of independent variable with 4 lags, and sum of negative change in the independent variable with 4 lags. The dependent variable will be from 1 to 4 lags, so this will not be from 0 to 4 lags because the dependent variable itself is with 0 lag. Okay. After specifying your equation in the equation specification box here and in the list of search regressors and selecting the stepwise least squares method, you need to go to options. Here in the selection method, choose unidirectional and here select the backwards. Now in this stopping criteria, you can select either p value or t statistics. So if you are selecting p value, you can select any of the level of significance. If you want to check a 10% level of significance, you can write this as 0.10. And if you want to check at 5% level of significance, then you can write down it as 0.05, right? Then weights. So if you want to specify the weight, then you can select any of these, or you can keep it as default as none. Right? After selecting all these options, you need to click on OK. These are the results for nonlinear autoregressive distributed lag model. Okay. These are the list of variables: constant, lag of dependent variable, sum of positive change with the lag value in the independent variable, and sum of negative change with the lag value in the independent variable. Their coefficient values, standard error, t statistic, and probability values. Okay. The R square in the model is 0.92. So approximately 92% of the variations in the dependent variable is explained by the independent variables. Okay. The coefficient of dependent variable is 0.0081 and that of positive change in independent variable is 0.136 and negative change in independent variable is 2.937. But these are not the long run coefficients. However, you can estimate the long run coefficient by following a procedure. These are the coefficients. 0.1361 is the coefficient of positive change in the independent variable and 2.937 is the coefficient of negative change in the independent variable. But to calculate the long run coefficients, you need to divide these two values by the coefficient of dependent variable, which is 0.008105, right? So dividing 0.1361 by 0.008 yields 16.7987, and similarly the other value of coefficient is 36.242 something. Okay, so how do we interpret this equation? The equation states that a 1% increase in the exports of a country will increase the GDP by 16.7987 units, and a 1% decrease in the exports of a country will decrease the GDP by 36.2424 units. Okay, so this is how you can interpret your results, and you can also estimate the long run coefficients using nonlinear autoregressive distributed lag model. Once you have estimated the coefficients and long run coefficients using nonlinear autoregressive distributed lag model, you can also perform the asymmetric cointegration test, and you also need to perform the diagnostic test. So in the next video, I will be discussing these topics. So I hope you like the video. Please click on the subscribe button and join the Telegram group also. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.